watching Shoe City School.
You're watching Shoe City School.
Exciting for us today to be welcoming a very special guest to Brockton who will be performing tomorrow night at the Shaw Center as part of the Cape Verdean Gala, the Cape Verdean Festival Weekend, sponsored by the Cape Verdean Association. I do want to take a moment first to recognize State Representative Mike Brady, who has joined us here today for this welcome. And I would like to give an opportunity for a couple of words from City Councilor at Large, Moises Rodriguez.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And thank you all for coming out on this beautiful, beautiful Friday morning. I think we're still in the morning hours.
Almost.
It's great to be here, and I can't believe how wonderful this this space has turned out to be. It's with a great deal of pleasure and honor that we're here this weekend, and we're honored to have with us one of the more beautiful voices from the Cape Verde Islands, someone that I adore because I love her music, and who doesn't know what Nati Nai is? And so it is with a great deal of honor and pleasure that I ask Luda to come up and say a couple words to you guys. Come on, Luda. You can say a couple things.
Hello, nice to see you here. Thank you very much for your reception. My English is very short, but I will try to tell you thank you very much. I'm always happy to be in United States, Massachusetts, Brockton, in a Cape Verdean community. I'm happy to be here again, to sing, to share my music with you, and that's all.
So I do want to, first of all, for our non-Cape Verdean guests here today, you should understand that Lura is one of the largest recording stars throughout Portugal and Cape Verde and is known all over Europe. And it is really a very exciting weekend for us in the city of Brockton. This, in our Cape Verdean community, is the biggest weekend of the year, every year, anyhow. But this year, I think, celebrating 40 years of Cape Verdean independence, 21 years of the Cape Verdean Association sponsoring the festival, and for our gala on Saturday night at the Shaw Center to be able to bring in such a well-renowned, highly regarded recording star such as Lura is a great day for the city. And so, on behalf of the entire city, Lura, I would like to officially welcome you here to the third Cape Verdean city in the world, Brockton, Massachusetts.
I'm from New Life Church here in Brockton, 184 West Elm Street. My pastor is Orlando Harris. Jesus said, if we lift him up, he will bring all men unto him. And so we are asking that you join us to walk for God.
Hi, I'm Michelle and this is Kathy. We're from Trinity Baptist Church. On behalf of Pastor Mark Oliver and Trinity Baptist Church, we invite you, the city of Brockton, to join us for a peace walk.
Hi, my name is Steve Warner. I'm the pastor of Brockton Assembly of God. This is Jerry Dunn, one of our deacons, and Donna, one of our members. And we are just delighted to be part of the Peace Walks.
Yes.
Our goal is to get out into the community and let people know that peace is not just the absence of conflict, it's the presence of God.
Join us with this Peace Walk. It's for anybody.
Hi, I'm Pastor Louis Lemieux from Love Alliance Church. We would love for you to come Peace Walk with us throughout the city and share God's love with the people of Brockton.
I want to encourage everybody to come out and walk with us for peace. We're going to be on the walk, and we're trying to get everybody to come out that we can to join us on the Peace Walk.
Hi, meu nome é Carla Ribeiro, instalei com o programa de Safe Corners Street Outreach Program. Eu queria convidar vocês na casa para bem achando, para não bem andar para paz, e também para não bem andar para ajudar o companheiro. No ódio de Deus, nós é só um, nós temos que ter boa ajuda. Por favor, bem, vem ajudar.
Venir andar com nós outros em paz.
Vem join nos para nos marchar ensemble por la paix por Brockton.
Hi, I'm Brockton Mayor Bill Carpenter. This summer, we're working with faith-based organizations from across the city to walk for peace. I hope you'll join us.
If you see a pothole, report it using C-Click-Fix. Log on to our website at brockton.ma.us. Click C-Click-Fix under Announcements. After, type in your address and select Next. Under Category, select Pothole, and under the description, explain the exact location. After, click Submit. Within a few days, you'll receive an email updating you on the status. And don't forget, you can download the C-Click-Fix app on your smartphone.
Hi, I'm Brockton Mayor Bill Carpenter with just three words for you. C-Click-Fix.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's also a great privilege to come up here and call up on a person who has been done that has been doing a lot for the Caribbean Association, who is willing to ask to whenever we need anything, just as you know, call my cell phone, I'll be there. It's a great honor and privilege to call up the mayor of this great city of Champion, Mayor Bill Carpenter.
Good evening, everyone. Boa noite. First of all, I want to congratulate Joe and Melissa on the birth of their daughter yesterday. Congratulations. Let's hear it for them. Third child. He looks awfully young for three children, huh? It's a great privilege to be here. This weekend has really become another of the great annual events in our city. 21 years now celebrating Cape Verdean heritage, culture, music, and arts. And I want to express my appreciation to the Cape Verdean Association for putting together another great celebration this weekend as we look forward to both the performance later this evening and all the festivities tomorrow at the festival. I think perhaps, I can't stand in front of the painting. Even more important this weekend, it is so significant as we recognize 40 years of Cape Verdean independence this year. 40 years. Now with this very large crowd, you can't recognize everyone who's here, but I do want to mention just a couple of officials who are here with us. First, I would be remiss if I did not recognize, he was just up here, but the other Cape Verdean elected official here in the city, City Councilor at Large Moises Rodriguez. We also have here with us from Plymouth County, we have the Plymouth County District Attorney Tim Cruz is here, and the Plymouth County Sheriff Joe McDonald is here. and they are both great friends to the city of Brockton. And we also have a couple of our state representatives. You know, we're working very hard on the city level, but we can't do things by ourselves. We need strategic partners. And since the first day I came into office as mayor, I've had two state representatives helping me tremendously, and I would just like to recognize them, State Representative Mike Brady and State Representative Claire Cronin. Thank you to both of you. They are both great friends, not just to the city, but to the Cape Verdean community. I'll be really brief. It's been 18 months now since we became the administration and I was sworn in as mayor. And it's very important for me tonight to be here with my Cape Verdean family, because I do feel as though we're family. But we are family. And 18 months is not very long, but I think it is important to know that we are making changes, and we are changing the way city government operates here, and we are changing, creating opportunities, and making sure that the Cape Verdean community is prominent in our government. We've done it with starting right off with the board of the Cape Verdean Association. One of the first things we did is assigned a representative of the mayor's office and a representative of the police department to serve on the board of the Cape Verdean Association, because we want to make sure that we open up lines of communication and that we work together, and that's a commitment that we've made. We've done it with appointments to city boards and commissions, many, many appointments. But as an example, the first, my friend Joao, first Cape Verdean to serve on the city's licensing commission, so that when Cape Verdean business owners come in front of the license commission, they feel as though they have a voice and they have someone to talk to. We've hired the first Cape Verdean employee in the elections department, so that we can make sure our Cape Verdean citizens can exercise their right to vote freely. We've had our first Cape Verdean employee hired in the personnel department, so that we can make sure we're protecting the rights of our Cape Verdean employees. And perhaps even most importantly, we've sent our first class of police cadets, our first group of police officers hired under my administration, and we have 9 cadets at the academy. 3 of the 9 are Cape Verdean, 7 of the 9 are minorities. It's the first ever minority-majority class of police officers in the history of this city, and we're very proud of them. So I just want you to know that I know that as I serve as mayor from time to time, you may not agree with me on a particular issue, and that's okay, because we're family. So when I go home sometimes, my own family that I live with does not agree with some of the decisions that I make as mayor, and they're not bashful about explaining to me why they think I'm wrong. But that's okay. But what my family knows, and what you should know, is that when your family, even though you may disagree once in a while, it doesn't mean that I don't care about you, that I don't love you, and that I don't always have your back, and that I'm not always there to help you. And I feel the same way with my family at home, and I want my friends in the Cape Verdean Association to feel the same way. We may not agree 100% of the time, but I am a member of the Cape Verdean community. I love you, I'm here for you, and I'm ready to help you in any way I can. Thank you.
In Brockton, we swing for the fences so we can touch home.
We coach in Brockton to instill the teamwork that builds a great winning tradition.
We do business in Brockton because here you can find a taste of home away from home.
We keep our company in Brockton because we love this city.
When Brockton is home, everything is within reach.
Great municipal golf course. Come over and check out DW Field Golf Course here in the city of Brockton. We've made a major investment in the DW Field Golf Course this year. The playing conditions are spectacular. It's an 18-hole public course. We are serving beer and wine now. We're able to handle tournaments there now. So come on over and check out DW Field Golf Course.
Música.
homem morna de serenata do Crejeu, que mar azul colhou nascer, solta quem tá na coladeira, traz a cantar de uma missão por te cumprir, porque escolhi teu jeito a ver, dignificar esse dom. Essa é minha vivência, que partilhava a tua gente, partilhava o mundo inteiro. História de um povo, história de uma vida. E só, de moda boa.
from New Life Church here in Brockton, 184 West Elm Street. My pastor is Orlando Harris. Jesus said, if we lift him up, he will bring all men unto him. And so we are asking that you join us to walk for God.
Hi, I'm Michelle, and this is Kathy. We're from Trinity Baptist Church. On behalf of Pastor Mark Oliver and Trinity Baptist Church, we invite you, the city of Brockton, to join us for a peace walk.
Hi, my name is Steve Warner. I'm the pastor of Brockton Assembly of God. This is Jerry Dunn, one of our deacons, and Donna, one of our members. And we are just delighted to be part of the Peace Walks. Yes. Our goal is to get out into the community and let people know that peace is not just the absence of conflict, it's the presence of God.
Join us with this Peace Walk. It's for anybody.
Hi, I'm Pastor Louis Lemieux from Love Alliance Church. We would love for you to come peace walk us with us throughout the city and share God's love with the people of Brockton.
I want to encourage everybody to come out and walk with us for peace. We're going to be on the walk, and we're trying to get everybody to come out that we can to join us on the Peace Walk.
Hi, meu nome é Carla Ribeiro, instalei com o programa de Safe Corners Street Outreach Program. Eu queria convidar vocês na casa para bem achando, para não bem andar para paz, e também para não bem andar para ajudar o companheiro. No ódio de Deus, nós é só nós temos que ter boa ajuda. Por favor, bem, vou ajudar.
Venir andar com nós em paz.
Vem joindo para nos marchar ensam por lá para o Brockton.
Hi, I'm Brockton Mayor Bill Carpenter. This summer, we're working with faith-based organizations from across the city to walk for peace. I hope you'll join us.
My name is Daryl Ellison, and I lost my only son, Carl Evan, in a hit-and-run accident. Carl was a joy beyond words. He was fun-loving. He had a great sense of humor. He had a strong work ethic. He went on at 16 years old, got a job at Shaw's Supermarket, and he worked there until the day he died. He was a very giving person. He never had any money. He was always giving his money away. He would pay for homeless people's meals, whatever he felt they needed. On Sunday, September 28th, Carl had just finished his job at Shaw's in Brockton, Massachusetts. He had crossed the street to go to the 7-Eleven. He was leaving the store at the corner of Belmont and West Street when he was struck and killed at 9:22 p.m. A surveillance camera picked up the vehicle as it was leaving the scene. Police believe the vehicle that hit Carl was a silver or gray minivan. It would have front end damage. There is a $5,000 cash reward for information leading to the apprehension of the person or persons responsible for Carl Evan's death. If you have any information, please call the Massachusetts State Police at 508-923-4205 or the Brockton Police at 508-941-0234. You may also send an email to justiceforcarl@hotmail.com. And to the driver, I believe that you are watching this. This must be a tormenting secret for you to keep. Please turn yourself in. And to those protecting you, please help your loved one do this. Carl Evan was my loved one, and he deserves justice. This is my quest. I have faith that you will do the right thing.